So the first one is about the most important API design principle question mark. And what is this all about? We are working, I'm working for KDAP. We do Qt, OpenGL, and C++. And in our line of work, we have found that Qt has one problem. It's this. Yeah, sorry, old joke. Qt has its own containers, and they are copyright cow. So. And they are all over the place. It's not like they are there for you to use. They are used all over the place in Painter API, in all the widgets, everywhere. So you can't escape them. And so users at this point in time may have come to rely on them by name, QVector, QList, and maybe even for the fact that they are copy on write. They may actually depend on this in their own code. So Qt containers are not going to go anywhere anytime soon, unfortunately. At the same time, Qt containers maybe are the biggest drawback that Qt has. So if you ask someone about Qt and modern C++, they say they have their own containers from the 90s. And that's correct. And this is basically a poster child how Qt is not modern C++. So for years, I've been thinking about how can we escape, how can we drag Qt out of that corner into which it backed itself during the 90s and aughts. So what would an exit strategy look like from the Qt containers? And in my work with QStringView, which is the StringView equivalent for QString, I've come across an idea for a new API design principle. And since I hopefully am the first, I get to name it, and I call it NOI. Come on, this is at least easier to pronounce than R-A-I-I. So anyone guess what it stands for? Hint, NVI. Non-owning interface. So what's this all about? So the idea is that you do not use owning containers in your interface of your class. But I need to put that standard string into, it has 15 kilobytes of data. I need to move it into my class. Yeah, but do you know whether the class author chose to actually store that data as a standard string? If you use standard string in the API, you're all but forced to use standard string in the implementation. So maybe he wanted to use one of John Larkos' fancy allocators with a standard vector. Who knows? So what, you say, should I use instead? How do I get my data in? And the answer is use views, right? An important part here is use it for setters, that's kind of clear, and getters. I will show you an example how this from Qt, how this worked pretty nicely. So what does this bring us? As I said, the implementation now is free to choose whatever container it wants internally. So the class author has done some benchmarks and statistics over the use of the class and has determined that fixed size buffer of 64 bytes plus a standard vector with pool allocator works best. Okay, he can use it. It's not exposed in the API. And on the other hand, the API user is also free to choose the container. They can continue to use the Qt containers. They can change to C arrays. They can change to standard vector. And of course, yes, there are associative containers. We don't have views for them yet. Maybe we will never have views for them. But as I said, it's an idea for an API. And I want to plant this seed in your heads, and maybe next year we'll come here and talk about it again and see where it's gotten us. So how does the exit strategy for Qt under this idiom would look like? So the first one is to apply that NOI. So remove the containers from the API, use views. For setters, that's trivial. You can use the same function name, you can use overloading, and the old code will still work. For getters, we need to provide a new story for users. And that story needs to be better than what we have right now. And that story is use views, use getters that return views and not owning containers. And once we have put all the users onto that new story, then we can phase out the Qt containers in Qt. So how would that story look like? Here's an example. In Qt, we have a class called QRegion. It's basically a collection of rectangles that represents a shape, a mask on screen. And in the worst case, one rectangle is one pixel if you have something really weird. But there's also a very common case where you expose a window and you get an exposure event, and then you have just one rectangle. So there's an optimization for zero and one rectangles where internally it's not allocating memory, but just storing it in line, like a small string optimization. So code that actually wants to inspect a variant, a region, needs sooner or later iterate over that list of rectangles. And if you're in performance critical code, this is what people did. So they asked the region, what's the rect count? And if the rect count is one, they did not use rects because that would create a container that would allocate. So instead, they called bounding rect. And the bounding rectangle of one rectangle is the rectangle itself. So, and otherwise, they would iterate over the list. So this code was actually in Qt. So in Qt 5.8, I made QRegion iterable. So by just adding begin, end, cbegin, rb, and so on, that works. And now the code looks like this, in all cases. Right? There's no special handling anymore, because we never create a QVector. If we used inline storage, we return begin from that and end of that, and otherwise, if we have a vector, we return vector begin, vector end. And this actually, in one of the libraries, saved 3 kilobytes in text size. Okay, if you have a multi-megabyte library, who cares about 3 kilobytes? But as we have seen, the code was optimized to avoid that one allocation of a vector. So apparently, that's needed. And this 3 kilobytes is over about half a dozen or a dozen users of that pattern that I showed you. And it's probably because QVector of QRect is no longer instantiated in that shared object. So string views, I said, is the same category, and that brought me to the idea. And the question then becomes, is NOI the most important API design principle? And, of course, the jury is still out there. For Qt, I have the feeling that maybe it's an existential question, whether Qt will continue to be a part of the C++ community depends on how quickly I feel it can shed its containers. For the rest of us, it's maybe worth a thought, right? And that's what I said, I want to plant that seed in your heads and then see what comes out of it. And with this, I thank you.